So for anyone who's new to this training session series, I'd just like to briefly go over the webinar ground rules. So just to reiterate, today's topic is about Autodesk BIM 360 Glue, the July releases for clash status and the new easy, accurate measurement tools. As usual, we're going to keep the webinar within half an hour and plan on ending by 4:30 Eastern time. We want to be respectful of your time, so thank you for that. And usual format, all the conference call participants are anonymous to non-Autodesk participants, and everyone is muted during the call. That being said, if you have any questions or comments or feedback, we encourage you to use the GoToWebinar questions dialog box. There will be time at the end for a Q&A session, so if you guys have any questions, please fire away. So now I'm just going to let's get started. So first I'm going to summarize the four or five topics that we're going to cover today. And then when I'm done with that summary, we'll dive into the live demo in the BIM 360 Glue product. So our major focus today for BIM 360 Glue will be the new clash status functionality. So as you can see in the clashes overview, we have this new concept of setting clashes to, whoops, sorry, I hit the button by accident. Setting clashes to a status in order to enable easier tracking of active and resolved clashes so that you can focus on resolving the most critical issues. And there have been improvements to the filtering capabilities to allow you to filter clash results by review status and notification. More detail on this in a little bit. We're also going to talk about clash markups. So now when you're reviewing clash results in the model, you can simply add a markup directly to the clash in the model in the drawing area. It makes it much easier to communicate any issues to the team. Clash markups are available not only in Glue Desktop, but also in Glue Web and the mobile app. So one thing that I want to emphasize is that the new clash enhancements are available for new and previously existing models. So if you're working with data or models that have been in the system prior to this July 2014 update, as shown in the images here, you may be prompted to click the Update Your Models Now link when you go to create a new clash test or rerun an existing clash test. This one-time process will ensure that going forward, your clashes, any clash results, comments, and resolved clashes can be tracked across future model versions. So this is just a one-time process that in the user interface, if you need to do it, you will see the Update Your Models Now link, and then you can simply click that and then wait for it to update, and then proceed with the clash analysis. The next thing we're going to cover is enhancements to the point-to-point measuring tool. And I'll do a demo of this. Just basically, when you use the point-to-point tool, Glue automatically calculates X, Y, and Z differences between objects for greater accuracy and, you know, just make it easier to pinpoint your measurements. And the July release also included updates to the BIM 360 added apps for Revit, AutoCAD, and Navisworks. And the 2015 versions of these added apps are now available in App Manager. And I also wanted to communicate to everyone that there is a newly launched BIM 360 community site. And so we're just going to go over this, and I'm encouraging you all to participate in the forums, get your questions answered, and you can also use the new BIM 360 idea station to contribute any ideas about current workflows, any ideas that you have to improve the product, to improve the workflows. We'll get into more detail about that towards the end of the demo. Okay, so that was a summary. So now let's go into Glue. And I'm going to demo the new clash status feature. So what you're seeing here is we have a previously run clash analysis. So for anyone that's new to clashes, the first time you run a clash analysis, you're going to see this clashes overview module. If you don't see that, or I should say, if you're rerunning a clash test, to see that, just click overview here, and it'll appear here. So at the top, under status, you can see our new clash status levels, and underneath, you see automatic grouping of active clashes per model. So the first thing I'm going to discuss is these new clash status levels. So when you run a clash analysis, by default, everything will be open. An open clash is basically anything that's new that hasn't been addressed yet and hasn't been set to one of the other levels. So an open clash is one that you basically need to address. One of the key enhancements for this release is if you have an open clash and you've sent a notification, a markup, or a comment, the clash ID and any of this added data will be maintained across future model versions. So rerunning a clash analysis will not blow away any comments that you made to the clash. They'll be sustained throughout the process of resolving any clashes. The ignored status is something that can be set by anybody on the team. So it can be set by either model contributors or VDC BIM managers. So basically, something that you set to ignored is something that the team doesn't need to address, something that you don't need to fix. So for example, you have electrical penetrations through slab that you aren't true clashes. They're as designed. You can simply set them to ignored. You can set that clash group to ignored, so that the team knows that it doesn't have to be addressed. The closed status is an admin-only feature, so only a product admin can set an ignored clash to the closed status. So it's at their discretion to set anything that's been set to ignored to closed. The resolve status is a system-generated status to identify clashes that have been resolved. So you've run a clash analysis, and then the clash has been addressed or updated in the authoring tool, and then you've rerun the clash test. If the clash has been fixed or resolved, it'll automatically be set to resolved. So with the new clash levels, what you can do is you can filter, you can select any of the links here, and what happens is this filtering displays over here in the classes dialog. Related to that, for active classes by model, this helps you to pinpoint sections of the model that you want to address. So for example, structure versus mechanical, there are 346 classes here. Select the link, and then it's also grouped over here, and then you can filter based on the status levels here. So this allows you to pinpoint what you want either yourself or someone on your team to focus on. Another new feature is that you can track and filter notifications by either those that you have sent or have been sent to you. So I'm going to put this back to ungrouped by back to ungrouped. And for notifications, I want to see what was sent to me so that I can simply filter out anything that I'm not responsible for. Likewise, you can also see what classes you've sent to other people on the team. And the status filter, you can filter by open, ignored, closed, or resolved here as well. Okay, so let's set this back up to the default. So now let's take a look at a class in the model. So actually, why don't we, let's open up that group again. So let's go structure, and then you drill down into a group. Let's select this individual class. Take a look at it in the model. So a new feature for this release is now you can directly just add a class markup right into the model. So the way to do that, after you've selected and zoomed into a class in the model, in the dialog here, you can see the tools. You can set class status here. You can also select the markup tool here. So when you select markup, then you'll see the red line tools, and you can either add linear markups, you can also add text. And then just make sure you save it. And then you can see over here, this markup icon appears to indicate that a markup's been added to this class directly in the live model. So I also just want to restate that this capability of adding the markups is available not only in the desktop, but also in the web access feature for reviewers, and also to anybody in the field using the Glue mobile iPad app. So if you're using the iPad app and you add a class markup on the iPad, it automatically syncs to anybody that's reviewing the project on desktop or on the web. So if anybody has any questions, please add them in the dialogue, and we can address them towards the end of the demo. Okay, so what I'd like to show now is the enhancements to the measuring tools. So we're going to go back to the toolbar, select measure. Actually, let me close out of that. So the point-to-point measuring tool has been enhanced, so I'm going to go ahead and select point-to-point. Okay, so what you're seeing here, the reason why it's in the bottom left, we're zoomed out a little bit too far. So actually, let me clear that, try that again. It's not doing what I'm expecting it to do. So I'm going to select point to point. Okay, that's what I expect to see. So what you're seeing now is the X, Y, Z differences between the objects. So where this is really can be useful is when you're looking at clearances in clash results. You can use the enhanced point-to-point tool and just get a more accurate measurement, more precise. And the way that you set the way that you can control your measurement settings, go to the profile menu, options, go to the advanced tab, and then you can set fractional precision, decimal places, make your changes here, and then hit save. Okay, so the next thing I'd like to cover is the new BIM 360 community site. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to launch the online help. So you see the help icon here. Launch the help. Here's the help landing page. Underneath Get Social, we have a link to the new BIM 360 Product Support Center. So these are new support forums, so I encourage everyone to participate, join the community. You can get questions answered here. These forums are monitored by product support and people across the BIM 360 team. You can also search here, search for threads where you can find answers to any questions that you might have. I encourage you to do that. The other thing I want to show you quickly is this new BIM 360 Idea Station. So this is a site where we really want to get your feedback, suggestions to improve the workflows, things that you're having trouble with. So I encourage everyone to go ahead here, add post, and it's a really great way for us to improve the usability of BIM 360 Glue. And the last thing that I just wanted to mention is that for the BIM 360 add-ins, for those that might not be sure what they are, this is so you can glue your models directly from your authoring tool, Navisworks, Revit, AutoCAD. You can glue them from your authoring environment directly into BIM 360. So this BIM 360 add-in site, here is where you can download the apps for whatever your authoring tool is. And I'll just show you once again, there's a link in the help to install BIM 360 add-ins. There's a link to the website here. And what I would just suggest, bookmark this page. These are continually updated, so it's good to have the link just so you can know that you're using the most up-to-date version of this. Okay, so I think we have about 10 minutes for questions. Any questions? Be happy to try to answer anything, any more information or any more detail that you'd like to hear.
Hi, Mike. It looks like we do have some questions coming in. First one here is, can I add Clash markups on the iPad?
Yes, you can. Yeah, great question. So the Clash markup functionality is virtually identical between the desktop and the iPad. So what you would do is you're looking at a Clash. Let's zoom into a different one. Just very simply click markup. It's a freehand tool. Make your markup, any comments that you want to add direct to the model, and then save it if you're on the iPad. Once you save it, it automatically syncs back up to the project, back to the live model. So no matter where anyone is looking at the model, they'll either be able to view the markups or add them.
Great. It looks like some people are raising their hands, so I'm just going to encourage everyone to ask your question in the question dialog box on GoToWebinar. So it's at the bottom of your panel there, and then we'll be able to answer those in the order we receive them. The next question here is, can clashes that are set to closed be reopened?
Yes, great question. So, like we said previously, closed is a setting that's admin only, and it's at their discretion to set something to closed. If the admin decides that, for example, something you thought you didn't need to address during the pre-construction phase, should be addressed, you can simply just reopen it. Or you could also set it to ignored.
Okay. And next question, are Clash IDs and comments maintained after rerunning a Clash analysis?
Yep, that's a great thing to remember. So one of the great things about this release is any clash IDs, any comments, they're persistent. So the next time that particular set of objects, the next time the clash is rerun, those IDs remain the same. So it makes it much easier to make your changes in the authoring tool and then rerun it and then see where things stand. It's pretty big enhancement to the workflow.
Okay. Thank you, Mike. This is really great. It's a great overview. Thanks, everybody, for joining us today. I'll see you in 2 weeks.
Thanks, everybody. I want to mention just one thing quick. If you have any questions, I encourage you to use the forums or any comments. We're always looking for feedback. So I appreciate your time today. And I strongly hope that you guys all take advantage of the community because we'd love to continue to hear from you.